is a terror of God. When we are in sin, God giving many, many opportunities, He leaves the people of Israel go as a slave to Babylonians, go into the hands of Egyptians, go into the hands of Persians. There you learn what is the meaning of without God. When Moses, God is calling, telling Moses, go and talk to the rock, the water will come. Moses tells those people, you are making fun of me, come man, I will show who I am. Instead of honoring the Lord and obeying the word, he says, I will show who I am, come on. In his tension with other people, challenging others, he forgot to listen to the voice of God. Earlier, first the Lord told him, take your staff, hit the rock, you will get the water. This time, God has told him, speak to the rock. So he went there and all took the staff and he was running. Everybody is running. Come on, let's see what this great Moses does. They are making fun of him. He was so angry, he was biting his teeth. And as soon as he reached that rock, instead of talking to the rock, as the Lord said, he took the staff and hit it. No water, because that's not what God has said. And those fellows started to laugh. Moses got so upset. Again he is hitting. God is merciful. Even when we have hurt, when we have sinned against him, God will humble himself to protect us in front of others. But when we are alone, he will tell us, you will die in your sin. Now, when he hit him second time, God brings water out of the rock to protect his servant in front of others. And then, when everything is over, now Moses is so happy. I approved. I am a great man. God says, come. You are an old man. You get unnecessarily angry. Stop here. I'm not going to allow you to proceed. He says, what, Lord? What are you talking? Do you know what you are talking? 40 years I struggled. I stood with the Pharaoh and brought them out. And now you are telling me I will not go to the land of Cana. What is this? I have reached the border. Just I have to put my steps, that's all. The Lord says, I have said it, don't ask anymore. That is it. I have said it, don't ask it anymore. That is the story. Us. Don't ask anymore. That's why the Lord says to the servant, even if the prophet Samuel comes or Moses comes, I will not listen to them. What I wanted to do, I will do through you. That is the end. No more ask. Paul says, Lord, there is a kind of weakness in me which is not going away. The Lord said, don't ask anymore. I'm not going to remove that weakness from you. That weakness is needed for you to depend on me all the time. I'm not going to take it out. Don't ask anymore. There is a side called terror of the Lord. The Lord cannot tolerate certain things in our lives. I'll give you one word for you. Take the book of Hebrews, chapter 10, 26. Kindly, somebody read, please.
For if we willfully persist in sin, after having received the knowledge of there no longer remains a sacrifice for sins.
Even any amount of sacrifice for sin you do, God will not accept that sacrifice. The word of God very clearly says, if we sin willfully after we have received the knowledge of the truth, there remains no sacrifice for sin. The wages of sin is death. Yes. But the truth is being given to us in the book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 13. We by ourselves cannot conquer sin, cannot live a life of God. So what to do? So the Lord finds the way. That's why Paul says, what I want to do, I am not able to do. What I am not supposed to do, I am doing it. So what a miserable being I am. What a wretched being I am. The word he used is, what a wretched being I am. Having said that, then when he looked at the Lord, he got the answer. Now what to do? He says, thanks be to Christ on the cross. What is the meaning of it? I cannot live by my sin. So all my sin, I have to go and give it to him. And with what he gives, I need to live on. The wages of sin is death means, number one, it will come in the physical death. On all kinds of sickness, disturbance, headache, all that will come. Family death, the love between husband, wife, parent, children, all will dry out. And financial death, whatever you work hard, yearn, nothing will remain in your hand. Everything will, someday it will go away. Physical death, economical death, and even not only the family, but also the peace will go away. The relationship with the people will go away. These are the type of death will come into our life. Various type of death will come. When this sin is there, we cannot handle. But there is a way which the Lord has shown to us. We can go to the Lord. We can surrender ourselves to the Lord and allow the Lord to rule our lives. Else, we cannot overcome the sin. But through the gift of the Spirit, through the gift of light, you have to dispel the darkness. So, what are we called to do? Our focus is more than what sin does. Our focus should be what the Spirit can give it to us. The moment we enter into the water, our thirst moves away. Yes, this is what the Bible says. You cannot conquer your sin, but you start to build up your life in the Spirit. If you are conquered by the Spirit, if you have the relationship with the Spirit, if you enter into the light, darkness moves away.